The presentation of the Food Global Conference on Health and Climate Change report is expected to provide the government with recommendations on how to maximize the health benefits of tackling climate change. The Pan American Health Organization PAHO Director Dr. Kerisi Etienne says it is important that small island developing states take action to protect lives from the impacts of climate change.
Climate change is costing us lives. It's taking lives, not only in the Caribbean, but far beyond the Caribbean as well. It is harming health. It is threatening livelihoods and hindering development. And it is no wonder that Britain declared a climate emergency. And I hope that the heads of states of the Caribbean will also declare a climate emergency for the Caribbean.
PAHO or WHO representative for Barbados and the Eastern Caribbean, Dr. Godfrey Shreb, believes the Prime Minister of St. Lucia will be a great voice to advance the action plan for health and climate change in the small island developing states.
St. Lucia is one of the leaders in the climate change revolution that is happening within the Caribbean, but also Prime Minister of St. Lucia takes on an important role next month when he becomes the head lead of CARICOM. And we hope that he will be the political vehicle within the heads of government for this document.
Grenada's Minister for Health, the Honorable Nicholas Steele, thanked the Pan American Health Organizations for its support towards the Action Plan for Health and Climate Change, which he believes will assist the region with becoming more climate resilient and protecting the future. PAHO and other high-level officials also got the opportunity to tour the Comfort Bay Residence for the Elderly facility, which is being retrofitted under the Smart Healthcare Facilities project. Reporting from the Communications Unit of the Ministry of Health and Wellness, I am Fennel Neptune.